I'm bored to tears with you. It's the same rap, Jim Cornette, over and over and over again.
Fuck Vince Russo.
Yo, I know you ain't talking about me, dog. You? What?
Fuck Vince Russo.
Been on my dick.
You fucking piece of shit.
Wait a minute. Let me tell you something.
Speaking of ballless, gutless pricks, Vince Russo. Hello, Vince. The ballless, gutless prick.
He's the only one that hadn't figured out that everybody's fucking seen through his fucking bullshit. It used to drive me crazy to be in the room with this motherfucker and I would leave with a twitch.
You are the shits and you're a goddamn piece of shit.
Fucking insane lunatic.
Dipshit.
Fucking piece of shit.
He's a failure. He's a fraud. He's a liar. He's a con man. And he's fucking pathetic. Running his dick licker. You piece of shit. I bet you can't even get your dick hard anymore, Vince. Because you're one of those Christian lunatics that thinks Hillary Clinton shouldn't have been president because woman was made from man's rib. So it must really give you erectile dysfunction, you fucking piece of shit, that you can't provide for your family and you're a failure and you're a laughingstock. Bret Hart said you ought to be hung in a parking lot. Because he's a gutless prick. He's a gutless backstabbing prick.
Russo, since he probably has a small penis, has to have positive feedback and reinforcement to make his ego grow.
Vince, shit-stained Russo.
He's never been in the fucking inside the barricade while a match is going on and he's writing the fucking show.
Asshole.
That I said I wanted to fuck his wife? Jesus fucking Christ, no.
This fucking clown, he's the only one that hadn't figured out that everybody's fucking seen through his fucking bullshit and don't want him around because he's gutless and he's desperate now. The goddamn waterfall of ignorance that comes out of his mouth, he's a fucking failure and he doesn't have a goddamn clue what he's talking about. You're an idiot. It's like everybody now is figuring out you're an idiot. Russo on a weekly basis begs for another job with the WWE.
Please, Vince, bring me back. Please, Vince, I need a job. Please, ain't nobody. Please.
Fuck you. What do you want to do? Fucking Holiday on Ice with chimpanzees?
Reading a television format written by Vince Russo was like reading something written by a man on LSD. This is the guy that got the restraining order against me because he was in mortal fear of me, and your fucking restraining order can get fucking torn up and shoved up your fucking ass real easy. He is a failure at life and a failure as a human being. We'll get to see.
He's a goddamn
stupid,
crooked,
ignorant,
heinous,
asshole,
piece of shit human being.
Let me just let all that sink in for just a second. Let's do what a lying sack of shit, whore, cunt.
I'm making it a mission now in my life.
Douchebag.
You're gonna go before me if I can make it to 93 just so I can stand there and take a whiz on your fucking headstone, pal.
I don't know. Russo's an asshole, baby. That probably explains that. He's failed at every wrestling venture he's ever had. I couldn't take listening to that fucking voice or looking at that goddamn puckered sphincter of a fucking face. Russo was whining and griping and squealing like a pig under a gate that I hated him and he didn't know what was gonna happen, and I've told him in the past I was gonna punch him in the face. He failed. Piece of shit, lying sack of snake feces he can't even spell, that I hope is somewhere in Colorado preparing to hang himself. That fucking goofy fucking douchebag. Anywhere in person, I will pick up whatever blunt instrument is handy and I will do what I've been wanting to do for 20 years, and that's cave your miserable fucking skull in and do the world a favor. Shit stain. Fuck. Hopefully this will make him just go ahead and just end it all.
Just thought we were just bros doing podcasts, man.
Just bros doing
podcasts.
So how does it feel to know that they finally fucking found out that you goddamn don't know what you're fucking doing? Fuck you.
What the fuck's the matter with you? Are you fixated on your grandmother?
He looks like a goof.
Or your grandfather.
Because he is a goof.
Motherfucker.
I want to puke. I think I'm just going to hospitalize.
Good old New York Vinny Room.
Because I just goddamn want to.
Well, I'll pay you guys for a shoot interview. You two in a room will get a uniformed police officer to sit in between you. I said I'll do it for free if you won't have the cop there. So let's see what two old, broke down, middle-aged white fucks can do. I want to beat the shit out of you, but I don't want to let you hit me, so I would hit you from behind with a table lamp. But I'm not supposed to be in the same place as you at the same time, which I'd be happy at this point to do. Everything I've ever said about you was true, and it's been proven from your own two measly lying little lips. Women don't want to fuck him, and no guy would want to suck his dick. I'm waiting for the goddamn picture of Vince Russo with a blow-up sheep, because even a self-respecting living sheep would not want Vince Russo to fuck it. I want him to die. If I could get away with murdering him and not go to jail, I would. I hate him worse than anything that has ever walked on this planet. The thought of him breathing
disgusts me because he's a failure in life, because he's toxic in this industry. You fucking fraud, you gutless coward. Do I have to call your wife crack whore? You never been in a fight, gutless pussy. Do I have to say your mother sucked dicks for dimes and dive bars? Do I have to tell you that your father gave government secrets to the Nazis? Because you probably do live in your in-laws' basement since you're an unemployed failure. Fucking ugly ass. You can't provide for your family. We've got a sad, desperate, unemployed, mentally unstable goof. And you're toxic and nobody wants to have anything to do with you. So send me a date, a time, and an address. I'll come to you. I'll come to you. Because I know you don't have money for gas, Vince. Being as you're in such a miserable state and you're living on food stamps, your wife's probably ready to divorce you. Not only will I come to you with no cops, no guns, no knives, but I'm going to have $5,000 in cash with me because I got that, Vince. I make a lot of money, which is more than I can say for that unemployed fucking loser. So what do I got to do? I'm going to do what the fuck I wanted to do almost since the first day I met your miserable ass on my mother's grave. You know it's true. I can whip you. Besides, it's not even going to be hand-to-hand because I said no guns, no knives. But I got a bat. I can find a stick. I don't give a fuck. And if you don't fucking take me up on that, you piece of shit, then shut your fucking dick licker from now on. Because I'm sick and fucking fed up with you. And everybody else is too. You've been found out. You've stabbed everybody in the back you've ever worked with. You've killed guys' careers with your goofy gimmick. You've made the wrestling business a fucking joke with your fucking ADD goddamn booking and your Jerry Springer show horse shit. And most of all, you're a piece of fucking shit, and I will prove it. Send me the date, the time, and the place, or shut the fuck up. Fuck.
Oh, well, I could listen to that all day, to be quite honest with you. Johnny's a musical genius.